All right, we're joined now by Dr. Kim Hammond from Falls Road Animal Hospital. And Vader just got a little excited.
Yeah, I spooked
this is Vader.
This is Vader. This is, believe it or not, a Doberman. This is a Doberman who hasn't had his ears cropped. And that's just so wonderful. You know, you don't need ears being cropped, and it actually hurts them. You know, people do it because they want to make the dogs look more attentive. And this is just a lovely, wonderful, beautiful dog.
Really nice dog. You have a new product you wanted to talk about.
Let me show you this stuff. This is the new latest and greatest flea product. You'll hear about it this year, and it is significantly different. If I was going to recommend a product, I would say don't go to the supermarket, don't go online. Mm-hmm. Talk to your veterinarian about this product called Activil Plus. It's a better product. One of the interesting things about this product, Sarah, is it immediately sort of affects the flea, sort of paralyzes the flea before it passes away. As a consequence, if you have an animal with flea allergies, they stop itching almost instantly because the fleas are paralyzed before they even die.
Guess what? We've got some questions, so we'll get to those. It's okay. We have a 10-month-old double doodle who came inside shivering this morning. I wonder why. Mm-hmm. After running around like crazy in the snow, how long can he stay out without getting frostbite?
It's a really good question. Rule of thumb, if you don't know, maybe no longer than you could stay out. Okay, that's just a quick rule of thumb. When the temperatures are in the teens, that's when you have to be very, very careful because they can just freeze very quickly. Yeah. So I would, without having to say 3 minutes or 5 minutes, if you're really cold, bring your dog inside.
Okay.
It's just a good rule of thumb. This kind of time of year, they freeze their toe pads before the rest of their body, and that's the thing that you have to watch out for.
So go with the way you're feeling. Okay.
Yeah.
Next one, I have a Holland Lop rabbit who constantly sheds. Is that normal?
It is sort of normal. This certainly is the time when they're going to shed. They're shedding kind of their winter coat, even though we're kind of going into winter. And the question is do we have too much shedding or do we have normal shedding? Mm-hmm. And that's something that has to sort of be discussed with a rabbit veterinarian. Dr. Herko at the Falls Road Animal Hospital, you can call him, it's free, and you can ask him specifically, and you can also send him pictures. You know, now we can do stuff online.
Right.
Take a couple pictures of your animal, send it to Dr. Herko and ask him.
Okay.
Shedding does occur in those animals a lot.
All right, we're out of time, but thanks for being here.
All right.
Thanks, Vader.
See you, buddy. Go home.
What?